Hello, fellow Grand Valley grads and alumni and others. My name is Chris Lyon, and I was a 1991 graduate of Grand Valley State University with a film and video major. Very proud to be a Laker, and I also have done quite a bit in the last however many years. I certainly don't want to admit how many years it's been. I did write a book in 2014 called A Killing in Capone's Playground. And in this book, I used a lot of my love of history, research, and genealogy. And that's what we're gonna talk about today, is genealogy, how to really research your family tree, but doing it the old-fashioned way, doing it with the basics. I mean, I know today there's a lot of options online, and I've certainly used them all. There's a lot of options that you can find online that will give you family tree information, that will actually sometimes even provide you with the names and the dates of everybody. But is it actually accurate? Do you know for sure that this is true? And so that's why, starting out with the basics, you can get a good feel for something when you first start out by doing it yourself. And then you can always add on to the extras once you get your branches out a little bit farther. But one thing that I always like to start out with when I do presentations is show this slide about genealogy. And it's really about, we think about our families, but it's really about us. It's who are we? Because it really is a unique to you and your full siblings. If it's just yourself, it's just you. But you have to look at this. Look at, you have, everybody's got two parents. Everybody's got four great grandparents. And you go down the line and you will find that you have a lot of relatives. When you get down, it's over 2 million just in this, just how much you could fit on this list. And I always like to think about, if there was ever a doubt in anyone's mind or in my mind that I wasn't meant to be here, I look at that list and I think, if one of those people in that list of over 2 million people that I have listed there didn't hook up, come together, meet, I wouldn't be here today. And so I am a combination of all of these people. And, you know, you can see what you want to see on the outside, but really on the inside, your DNA, the person that you are, is really a result of all of these people. And so it's important to be really open-minded and think, you know, I'm not just, I can't be labeled as one thing. And one of the things that I like to teach people is that you were meant to be, and if there's any question, that you aren't here for a reason. And so, and I think it's important also to honor our ancestors and honor their legacy, because they were the ones that brought us here. And we have the ability to do that today. But again, to start out with, you know, we're gonna look at our parents, our grandparents. We want dates of birth. We want marriage dates. We want death dates. We want any other dates that are important. And we also wanna know locations. Now, with the locations in genealogy, we not just want to include a city name, but we also want to include a county, because a county is where the records will be held. So if you're looking for specific records on a family member, remember where the county is that they were born, where they died. That's where you're going to find your original records. And this is going to take some time. This maybe even take some traveling. And I've done that too myself. Traveled around to see different places where they used to live and get a feel for what it was like. Now, one of the things, one of my favorite places to go is a cemetery. I'll admit it. Cemeteries are wonderful beginnings to tell a story. And a lot of times, you see old cemeteries where the stones are falling apart and you can barely read the writing on it. Those are the ones that are sad, because you figure this is a person here. This person was more than just a date. This person was more than just a name on a stone. And you kind of want to know a little bit more about that person. So this is where your research skills come in, and doing a little digging and a little thinking outside the box a little. Now, I think of genealogy as both an art and a science. Now, the art comes in where you're having to decipher cursive handwriting or very eloquently written ledgers. Sometimes people didn't write straight up, you know, plain, simple, easy to read writing. So you have to decipher a lot of that. Is that a Y? Is that a Z? I don't know. So you have to take into account a lot of the writing, a lot of art. You'll have to think outside that way. And then you also have to look at it as a science. You're dealing with a lot of dates, a lot of times. Okay, so if somebody gives you a date of birth for a woman and her child is born 10 years later, okay, odds are that that probably isn't correct, because usually 10-year-olds don't have children. I can't say that it's probably never happened, but it's probably not the case. So take into consideration dates too, and use again some common sense to follow that. That's what I would recommend. But one of my favorite things to do is to interview family members. This is one of the easiest ways to get really into their story, into their life, because you can see the dates on pieces of paper, but what were they like? What kind of a person were they? What did they do? What did they have that was interesting, an interesting life? Were they in the war? What kind of church did they go to? Who were their friends? And one of the things that I did learn through interviewing my ancestors and some other people was that I had a great aunt who was from Chicago, and she used to babysit Clayton Moore, who turned out to be the Lone Ranger on TV. So I'm thinking, here I watched the Lone Ranger as a kid and thinking that there's a connection with my great aunt. She used to babysit him. So I'm telling people that, yeah, my great aunt changed his diapers. You know, I don't know how old he was when he was being babysat, but it's just the fun little stories and little things you can find out. I also found out through a little bit of research that I am related to one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence. So I have some roots in the United States here. I also found out something very interesting, which was that when my ancestors on my father's side, which is the paternal side, immigrated from Sweden, they went to Liverpool as a stopover, and then they were going to come to Boston through the immigration process. And I found that their last name when they left Sweden was Manson, but when they arrived in America, their last name was Lion. So that was interesting to find out. Well, learning that again from talking to relatives, the story was that they had decided that they wanted to change their name. They didn't want to be associated with their home country. They wanted to start anew in America. And they supposedly looked up at a building and saw the name Lion written on it while they were in Liverpool and said, that's going to be our new name. Now, I wish I could verify that. I wish I could find that building that says Lion on it. But that isn't it. That's something completely different. That changes my whole history, because now I'm not technically a blood lion. I am technically a Manson. That would have been my last name. And it's probably a good thing, because I do have an Uncle Charlie, so he probably wouldn't appreciate having the Charles Manson name association. So some things are good and some things should be kept secret. But that was one of the interesting things that I found out. And again, these are stories that you're not going to find out on pieces of paper. You're going to find out from talking to people. Now, photo albums are wonderful. Scrapbooks, if you have those, grab those. A lot of times, my grandmother was an avid one of making sure that you write the names of the people on the back of the photos. You know, nowadays, we don't print photos anymore. And what are we going to do with these videos and all these digital photos that we have? We're going to have to find another way to save them. But we do have boxes of photos, and a lot of times you can find out what people looked like. They might have been in the service, military photos, places that they lived will all tell a story, and a lot of them in black and white. So, and it's hard to imagine life being in color when you were in that day, because everything is in black and white. And that always, that famous box in the attic, I always tell people that, you know, don't throw anything out. If you have relatives that have boxes of old papers and things, don't throw them out yet. Take a look at them, because a lot of them are treasures. A lot of them might be receipts from somewhere that they did business with. This company's now out of business, and this is an 80-year-old document now that might be relevant to something. I mean, it might say, well, this is where they went to eat, or this is where they got their oil changed and their car fixed. A lot of times those are very interesting and historical documents that somebody might be interested in. Family Bibles were always something that people used before before they had the law that you had to have a burial record. And a lot of times people would record information in their family Bibles. This is a very old Bible that's fallen apart, but it was my great-grandfather's from 1922. And a lot of it was in German, so I had to have somebody decipher it a little bit for me. Now, I also have another Bible that had some little handwritten notes in it. So you'd be surprised at what you can find inside of these little treasures. But the family Bible is always a good one to look at. Family heirlooms. I had a little dish set that my great-grandmother had. And having this, and then there was on the actual plates, there's a stamp that says where they were made. I could do a little research on that and look up the names, find out that it was actually pretty much a generic pattern. It wasn't anything specific. And then, of course, some of our relatives always had one of these, the potato masher. And this one was well used, and I inherited this. So I keep thinking about all the meals that people had where they had their potatoes mashed with this masher. But really, when you understand timelines of what was going on, you can really get into the idea of what people were dealing with. A lot of people immigrated before and after wars, and a lot of turmoil was going on in different countries. And you can trace that back to say that, you know, these people left, evil regimes, and they came over and they wanted to start a new life. And this is what it's all about, is trying to get down to the nitty-gritty of who these people were, what they did, who they were, and it's not just a name and a date. That's my goal with this, is to get you to go out, get some fresh air, walk through the cemeteries, go to the courthouses when they're finally open, get those vital records and look through and see who your ancestors were, because who your ancestors were is who you are, and honor their legacy, because most of them certainly don't have the kind of lifestyle that we have today. Everything is at our fingertips and so easy. They had hard lives, and learn from that. Talk to them and continue to honor their legacy by passing down this information then to your children, your grandchildren, and making sure that it is kept and that you do have an ultimate plan for where this stuff goes, because we certainly don't want to lose it. I don't want anybody to lose my Grand Valley diploma, because that's valuable. And I want to make sure that it has a place to go. I don't have any children, so I'm going to pass it down to some of my cousins and make sure that they get it out. But I am more than happy to take any questions, answer anything that you have going on, and give you some advice if you want. My email address is CaponesPlayground@gmail.com. Again, that's CaponesPlayground@gmail.com. See, I made it kind of easy since it's kind of the name of my book. So, but genealogy is something you'll be addicted to. You'll be hooked on it just like I am. Still using it today. And I hope that you will find the same and find a little bit something interesting and share your history with the rest of us, because we all have our own history. I'd like to thank you, and I hope that you have a wonderful day.